Boris, блять, do country view of Belgium. We love mayonnaise. We invented the holy combination of... Okay, hold on. You had me at mayonnaise. Yes, Boris! Пиздец. Belgium. So why the blin am I here? Well, I heard some friends were going and once they saw ticket price was as cheap as a 6-pack of vodka, I could not resist. And well, promises of mayonnaise always get me moving. This is by far the least Slav country I have ever visited. Once I stepped out of plane, one thing was very obvious to me. Everyone speaks French, unless they are speaking Dutch or German. And all of these three are national languages, none of which do I speak, so it was a lot of excuse me and si vous plaît. So okay, after we got a rental car, we had a street for pub, had a beer, it was okay. Walked past Polish embassy, said some kurvas and asked for some kielbasa, they did not give us any. So we went to shop and bought some kielbasa in box instead. Had a waffle at the nearest waffle place, we asked for one with mayonnaise but got syrup instead. But the waffle place just happened to be very close to statue of child that has very big bladder for some reason. Admired the local automotive scenery, especially that magnificent machine. I did not even know they made this. So, squatted around town in Brussels, drove around until found big atom in the center of city, and initiated squatting sequence. Soon it started raining, we found a pub, we went to have a drink, it was good. The next day we found a big hallway, and single sleeper on street, and some pants. Right next to European Commission building, we saw a very big glorious park, with bombs sleeping inside. Saw the Belgian police following an invisible suspect, and found coffee cup big enough for my Slav needs, and spotted around 5 billion Vespas around town. Spotted some precision driving in various places, and used the elevator that did not have any doors inside. Why would you build such a thing? Took the new bolt that I found out for some fresh air. Sadly, there was no anomalies to detect. We then searched for place of shashlik, which we did not find. We looked around for this massive variety of mayonnaise that this country should have, and found only 4. Come on, where are you hiding this stuff? Okay, 5 kinds, but still. So apparently, Belgium makes about 800 different beers and 200,000 tons of chocolate. So it should be no surprise that when we drove to city of Bruges, Bruges, the variety of chocolate content, hammers and nuts and bolts that I did try to eat, which, unless I have superhuman teeth, is actually made of chocolate. So we walked around just a little bit to find some of those fries that were promised to me. Опа! Beer o'clock! When we finally found place to buy some fries, it sadly turned out that they had just run out of mayonnaise. A sad day in the life of Boris. So we hit the road again. Lots of roads and lots of mountains all across the country. And apparently Belgium has the highest density of roads in the world. And that should be no surprise because it is neighbored by 4 countries. So, what do? Of course we drive to Luxembourg and pick some Luxembourg beer up on the way. It was okay. When we arrived at the city of low buildings and strange midday traffic jams, we took the time to find a nice little place for squat. And we were greeted by statues of squatting. Very nice, Boris approves. We soon came across a statue of angry monks, hinting us to leave this place. So, we did! soon to find out that unless you're local, you best get out of the way, because speed limits are just fancy signs to them. Everyone just drives at speed of fuck you. But it's more like a Belgian fuck you, it's sort of like, oi merde, my waffle is getting cold. The following day we went to see Brussels again, in all of its European Union glory. And the trams, of which there are many. To my biggest surprise in this whole trip, we did manage to find some quality street art. Mr. Invader, if you're watching, I'm a big fan. We saw a dog, and a strange gang sign. We saw Brussels at a Saturday morning, and met up with some fans that flew over just to see me. We saw many military vehicles, and a lot of armed guards that were not very happy to be filmed. So I took pictures of Adidas instead. I mean, I would not be surprised if I end up on some kind of watch list, as some strange yellow tracksuit wearing Slav squatting in every place. But no problem, as long as we order waffles with powdered mayonnaise, it's all good. So after seeing pretty much the whole of Brussels, we thought that, fuck it, let's try to Netherlands. And we did. And since there is pretty much no border sign between Belgium and Netherlands, then you really have to pay attention to small details to know which country you're in. Like for example, the ground being as flat as a blimp, and there being a need for a specific science. Like, hey, it is not okay to drive your tractor and bicycle on this road. When you see this, you know you have arrived. We got there, had a nice squad, saw a babushka on three wheels, most likely driving to nearest coffee shop. So, we did too, and it was good. But more of that another time, when I got to Netherlands again. So despite some setbacks and a severe lack of mayonnaise, Belgium is fun if you like... if you're into... The beer, yes, the beer was good. And if you like beer, you will like Belgium. But thank you for watching, my friends. This has been Professional Slav Superstar Country Review by Boris, powered by Shashlik. I will see you in the next country, my friends. Stay cheeki, breeki.